JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for February 24th. I am Charalambos, Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against the majority of the other G10 currencies on Tuesday and during the Asian session Wednesday. It gained the most versus CHF, JPY, SEC and the euro in that order, while it underperformed only versus the Kiwi and the British pound. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the Canadian dollar. Now, the weakening of the safe havens franc and yen, combined with the strengthening of the risk-linked Kiwi, suggests that markets traded in a risk-on fashion yesterday and today in Asia. However, shifting attention to the equity world, we see that this was not the case. Major EU indices closed mixed, with Spain's IBEX 35 being the main gainer and Germany's DAX the main loser. In the US, both the Dow Jones Industrial Average and the S&P 500 ended their trading fractionally higher, but Nasdaq slid 0.50%. Today in Asia, market sentiment deteriorated further. Yesterday, the main event on the agenda was Fed Chair Powell's testimony before the Senate Banking Committee. The Fed chief reiterated his stance that the economy is a long way from the employment and inflation goals, and that even if the labor market strengthens, the committee will not tighten monetary policy in response to that. With regards to scaling back QE purchases, he noted that they will clearly communicate well in advance any change, but they haven't seen the desired progress yet. Basically, he maintained his dovish rhetoric, which may have been the reason behind the recovery in equities during the US session. That said, as we noted yesterday, this was the base case scenario. In other words, it may have been largely anticipated, and thus the rebound did not last for long. Inflation fears returned and yields rebounded during the Asian session today. Overnight, apart from the rising yields theme, we also had an RBNZ monetary policy decision. The bank decided to keep its official cash rate and its large-scale asset purchase program unchanged, noting that they agreed to stay prepared to provide additional stimulus if necessary, with the options including a lower official cash rate. The Kiwi slid initially, perhaps as the statement may have revived speculation over negative interest rates by this bank, but it was quick to rebound, recover the losses, and trade even higher, perhaps as investors started scanning the quarterly monetary policy report, in which the economic forecasts showed that the official cash rate will turn higher from December. Now, our view, the probability for this bank to adopt negative interest rates remains slim, though it is not zero. After all, at the press conference, Governor Andrian Orr said that negative rates remain an available option. That said, for now, due to the bank's own projections, we see the case for the Kiwi to stay supported. We also believe that with monetary policy around the globe set to stay accommodative in the months to come, risk sentiment may improve at some point soon, which could support risk-linked currencies like the Kiwi, especially against safe havens like the yen. We see the case for equities to rebound as well, and thus we will treat the current setback due to inflation fears as a corrective phase. As for the rest of today's events, during the European session we get Germany's final GDP for the fourth quarter, which is forecast to confirm its preliminary estimate of 0.1% quarter over quarter. In the US, new home sales for January are expected to have accelerated to 2.1% month over month from 1.6%, while the Energy Information Administration is expected to show that crude oil inventories fell 5.190 million barrels last week, after falling 7.258 million the week before. That said, bearing in mind that the American Petroleum Institute reported 1.026 million barrels gain, we would consider the risks of the Energy Information Administration forecast as tilted to the upside. Now, as for the speakers, Fed Chair Powell will present his testimony before the House Financial Services Committee, but we don't expect him to say something new. We expect him to stick to his dovish stance. Apart from him, we will also get to hear from Fed Vice Chair Richard Clarida and Bank of England Chief Economist Andy Haldane. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the Weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So bye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.